Hi, this video is to show you the proper way to wire our SM Vector drives. I'm going to go over some general wiring practices and to show you how to do noise isolation. It is important to remember the correct wiring gauge during installation. You can find the wire gauge specs in the manual for the SM Vector drive for each model, as well as isolation and grounding methods will be discussed. Ideally, you should separate conduit for input power, output power, and control wiring. When connecting the VFD's power and control wiring, the following guidelines should be followed. 1. Install the input AC power wiring in its own rigid steel conduit. I have here a cable to illustrate that with the SM Vector drive. After you remove the bottom cover, you can see that we have our output wiring going out to the motor labeled U, V, and W, as well as the two ground screws, and then our input power connections are labeled L1, L2, and in this case, L3, three-phase drive. So by connecting the motor power wires to these screws, they would go in their own separate conduit, and likewise, our input power wiring would go in its own rigid steel conduit. Step 3 is to install the control wiring also in its own rigid steel conduit. Now, in case of an analog cable, the shield must only be connected to the drive's ground. Low voltage DC control wiring and 120 volt AC control wiring should ideally be in separate conduit, but we know with many panel designs this is not always possible. We say in the manual that this should be done, but we understand that it's not always an option. The cables for the digital connections must have their shield connected on both sides. The cables of the analog and digital inputs and outputs must be shielded cable. If control wiring is less than 8 inches long and unshielded cables are used, they must be used with twisted pairs to further reduce noise. Make sure that all your ground connections are tight and properly tied to earth ground to avoid ground loops. For proper grounding of a shielded cable, we recommend using what we call a saddle clamp, which is a 360 degree connection that goes around the shield of the cable itself. Now you can cut a small piece of the insulation in the cable all the way around and take about 1 to 2 inches out, and then use a type of saddle clamp that's going to work with the panel that this drive is being mounted inside. Not all panel setups are the same, so different clamps are typically used. We typically like to use either the clamp-on or the screw type to get a better bond to the body of the machine. Always use our drives on a grounded system. You should never use a floating ground. Lenza does not recommend operating with a floating input on any of our drives, except for systems using what's called an IT mains configuration. However, for the SM Vector drives, we do not have this IT mains separate connection screw. For the SM Vector drives, if there are no disturbances on the line, the drive should run fine. However, serious common mode noise can cause nuisance tripping. So it is important that these restrictions be observed. Okay, now I'm going to show you how to cut this power cable and expose the shield. And as you can see, I've done that with about 2 inches of space. And we're going to take this shield and connect it to what we call a saddle clamp, which has a 360 degree coverage. So what we want to do is we want to attach this to the machine's ground by attaching this clamp to the machine's back plane, the panel, so that both the ground of the cable shield and the machine itself are at the same ground point. The important thing to know is that the coverage for these, the more coverage that we have with the ground on these cables shields, the better, because it allows for better surface area connection for less noise that can interfere with the drive. Now this particular unit is very useful because it has a spring-loaded mechanism, so it can fit multiple different cable sizes. Another way to make sure that you have a good proper ground between the drive and the motor is to use what we call the spade lug connector. All of our SM Vector drives have a PE screw connection that goes to the earth ground. That's what PE stands for, protective earth. Now you'll notice directly beneath here that we have another provision for a different ground screw here, as well as a spade lug, which is this little tip on the end of the board here. Now the spade lug simply can have a connector from a piece of wire connect directly onto it, so it just slides right down. Now you can also use a eyelet on the end of your cable if you have that type of ground connection back to your motor, and you would just connect it there and then the screw would clamp down on that with a washer. And then the last thing is to use this small backplane, which is also like a saddle clamp, that will allow the drive cable to connect directly to either the body of the drive, you see screw connections here, or further down into the panel of the machine. And either way, as long as the cable for your control wiring is connected with the shield of this type plate, then the ground is going to be nice and firm and properly at the same potential as the drive, along with the cable going out to your motor.